everybody, ChristopherOdd here, and welcome back to XCOM 2. I know it's been a little while since we've picked up this playthrough, but if you haven't heard, our preview builds expired, and after that we were provided with an updated, but not final build of the game. It's called a review build, and in the review build, it's great because we can show you so much more content, so between now and specifically release, but obviously the foreseeable future, I'm going to be showing you guys a lot of cool things that I wasn't able to show you in the past. Now for this series specifically, I've loaded up the save file from the preview build so we can pick up where we left off, but it's important to note that there are some big changes coming, specifically to Legend difficulty, that are going to impact an overall playthrough. So on Friday, I'm going to start a brand new Legend playthrough with all of those balance changes being implemented. And it was just announced this week that those are finalized, so those aren't going to be in until Friday. So for this week, we're going to see how far we can get with this playthrough before we start fresh on Friday. And on Friday as well, I'll be looking to incorporate many more of you guys into the character pool, so stay tuned for a video on that. It was also announced that Firaxis had kind of partnered with the Long War Studios guys before release to create some mods that will be available on day one. So on day one, there's three mods that are going to be available. Number one is a new weapon type, it's an SMG. Number two is an upgraded enemy. And number three is a new soldier perk tree that's actually really unique. I love the implementation. And all of these mods, they don't really change like the base mechanics of the game. So I think the balancing aspect is going to be overall neutral, which is fantastic. So that's the game plan over the next little while, and I'll have some more details about how to join the character pool for the real Legend run that will start on Friday. But for now, let's just get back into this and see how far we can get picking up from where we left off. So what we want to do is we want to counter some of these dark events that might be happening. And when you're making a choice for guerrilla ops, I'm not sure how much I've talked about this in the past, but you do have to keep in mind a couple of things. Yes, there's the reward. Yes, there's the difficulty of the mission. But there's also, like, I think most importantly is usually the dark event that it's countering. Now, sometimes the dark events aren't that bad. Like, even the retaliation counter, you kind of think, well, that's not too bad. Guaranteed reinforcements on all guerrilla ops missions. It's not too bad. It's more experience for your soldiers and things like that. But if I had to choose kind of the worst of the two right now, I would say the retaliation counter would be most difficult, just given how new our soldiers are. So we're going to try and impact that if we can. So let's head out to West Asia. This is the squad that we had set up previously. I am going to go ahead and change Martha's gun back to the yellow, just because that's how I like it. Let's just take a quick review of the soldiers that we have. So we have Dandelion here, who's got his grenade launcher ability, so congratulations, that's very, very exciting, you've come a long way. We've got Olivier, who has grenade, blast padding, and demolition. And the way that I've kind of built these guys out, or I will build these guys out in this run, is sticking strictly to the archetypes that we've provided, so on either side of the tree. So we're going to build, like, as an example, with Martha. We'll build a true, like, assault ranger and see what she can do. And then if we have another ranger, we'll build a true scout and see what they can do. I have my preferences, definitely. And I prefer actually to mix and match as much as I can. But I'll talk about that in other videos. Hellscorn we have as well, who's got the Long Watch and the Deadeye perk. He's like our true sniper. And then we have Grellite, who's a rookie right now. In terms of items, we are going to carry one flashbang and a whole bunch of grenades. However, I may want to grab a couple of other things. Let's just take a look here. We have the nanoscale vest, which we could build. Wouldn't be a terrible idea to give everybody some additional health benefits. I think what I will do, though, is I'll bring a smoke grenade. And we'll try to show you guys just as much of this stuff as I can. So let's carry that in the back line with Hellscorn. And then for our rookie, we'll go ahead and throw on one of the vests that we have already. And with that, we should be good to go.
Sky Ranger deployed.
Menace, ready to deploy.
All right, let's go.
We've got a prime opportunity here to disrupt the aliens' progress on their latest operation. Intel suggests Advent is moving a secure data vault through this area on one of their trains, and the information it's carrying is critical to the aliens' efforts. We're moving to secure the train. Eliminate all hostile contacts and recover the assets.
Okay, so we're trying to neutralize all the enemies and recover a tissue sample analysis from the Advent train.
Menace 1-5, we've got a bead on the Advent data vault near your position. Be advised, self-detonating charges are in place at the target. Move to disarm and extract the package before its contents are destroyed.
Okay, Grellite. While you've proven yourself in previous playthroughs, you're currently a rookie, and so you're going to be leading the charge. This is a fair distance away. Now, one of the things that I've learned is that you can't... This is going to sound a little bit counterintuitive. But you can't really let the counter dictate how you play, and what I mean by that is, like, don't put yourself in really compromising positions if you don't absolutely have to. I would say in about 80% of the timed missions, I would usually finish on the very last turn. And so it's certainly well within the possibilities to get it done.
Moving to designated coordinates.
And I think the biggest challenge will be not rushing yourself to get something done, and then you end up in a really bad position. Okay, so let's keep Hellscorn up here for a little bit of height advantage. Everybody else, we can kind of funnel down below. Stuart, let's bring you in. And now we wait. Now, the other thing that's that hasn't been implemented in this build is the kind of nerf that they made to the Overwatch ambush to break concealment. So in the past, you could wait for a patrolling group to kind of walk into you on Overwatch. And if they catch you while you're flanked, which is what you wanted, you'd get a free Overwatch shot, and then it would be your turn again. They've changed that, but it's not in this build. So for the purposes of this playthrough... Or this, mini playthrough that we're going to do. I won't be using that tactic. I'm going to try and do it the traditional way. The fix that they've implemented for it is actually really well done, I think. And when it's updated, how it's going to work is that when they walk into you and they when they spot you, there's a chance that they will fire back at you right away. And if that happens, You could be caught out. They could get the upper hand on you, and there's a chance that your soldier just dies if you're the one that's spotted. So it's a lot more risky now, and I think it's a great change. Okay, so we have a couple of decent shots here, but I'd rather have our whole group be ready for this. So I'm going to move Dandelion up. I'm going to move Grellite up, and I'm going to move Martha over to the left. Should also see here, so we're working with a sectoid and a regular trooper. So for now, let's just hold up. Now this is the challenge with these timed missions and enemies that are patrolling. I try to give myself like a kind of a two turn maximum when I've spotted an enemy to make an attack, because otherwise you're just chasing them around, and more often than not, you're gonna end up in a situation where you've uncovered another group that you don't really wanna deal with, and it makes things a lot more difficult. So let's bring Stuart around here. We're gonna set up our attack. Hopefully it all goes well. I'm okay putting Olivier in front. He's got that extra little pip of armor there, which is pretty significant early on. And depending on where they scatter to, Hellscorn may get a shot off, he may not. But I think what I'm gonna do, you know, I'm sensitive to the fact that we don't want to totally just kill civilians here, although I have resorted to that in the past. But for now, I think we'll try and play it a little bit closer to the chest. Set up our ambush here. 68% or 69 with Stuart. We'll take the 69. All jokes aside, let's see what happens. There we go. Game on.
We've been spotted.
That's a nice cinematic view there. There you go. Beautiful. Well done, guys. Didn't even need Hellscorn. Well done. Now, there were some people asking, like, well, how come the guys are so accurate in concealment? And the way concealment works is that you don't have the traditional Overwatch penalties, and so your shots are just as accurate as they would be if you were shooting normally. Hellscorn, let's just get you in here. We need to keep making progress. Okay. What do we got here? So we've got an officer and two troopers. That's good. By good, I mean terrifying. These officers are deadly. I kind of think of them as like the new... I know everyone's going to say, well, the Viper is the new Thin Man. But like, these guys are really accurate. They can apply targeting, which has a pretty substantial drawback for us. I think this is a good opportunity, though, to blow up his cover, do some damage, hit the guy on the left. I wish I could blow up both of their covers, but I don't think that that's going to work. So let's go for it, Olivier. There we go. And we got the 4 damage on it. Beautiful. Okay, Grellite. Now, I'd love to say that you're totally fine just standing there in the open, but that's not going to happen. So he is flanked. Let's see what we can do. Our guys are on point today.
Good riddance.
This is great. But as we know, that could change pretty quickly if we're not careful. I'd like to go up top here, but we're blocking it with Olivier. And I don't really have a great spot to put Dandelion. Maybe we put him inside? It's actually not a bad idea. Let's bring him in. And Martha, we're going to need to run in as well. Let's hide her back here for now. Okay. We're gonna have 4 more turns. Don't need to panic quite yet. Oh yeah, you would Overwatch, wouldn't you? Well, let's do this. Let's try and get rid of the cover that's in front of him. I'll try to expand these things as often as I can because I know people like seeing that stuff. I actually do too, and I haven't figured out a way to just make sure that's always up, but as soon as I figure that out, I'm gonna make that happen. There we go. It still has the Overwatch, but we have decent shots from here. Oh, Hellscorn can't see him. That's too bad. Grellite can't see him. Oh, really? Thought we'd have much better shots. I'm thinking we could kind of skirt along this wall.
Let's see.
Yeah, we're good. Let's go, Dandy. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful.
Enemy descend.
Okay. We got 4 turns. No need to panic. Everything's going great.
Moving on target.
Just gotta keep telling myself that every once in a while. Now, we are gonna have to make some pretty aggressive moves here towards the end, but I'm thinking of putting Martha up here, but I think that's a bit risky.
Moving.
So I'll keep her in the open for now.
Scanning. Overwatch.
Overwatch.
-1-5. The clock is ticking. That detonator isn't going to wait. Get to the vault and disarm it before we run out of time.
Yeah, well aware. Thank you. Thank you. One of the things I don't think I've shown in the past is that if you hover over your soldier's name, it'll bring up all their stats. So their health, aim, hack, will. The one thing I wish it would show is mobility, but that's, you know, pretty visual. You can also, if they have a buff or a debuff, you're able to kind of hover over that and it will show you what those are impacting. Let's go ahead and take the free reload here. Grellite. Let's see. If you make it here, this is a good sign. What would be the worst? Okay, good. So I think we're safe from enemies on the left. And I kind of want to tuck Grellite just up here. We do have grenades in case something crazy happens. And we have a flashbang as well. Which is like,
what animal is this
so
anyway?
Good. What did they, what did he just say? Was he referencing the graffiti on the wall? I feel like he may have been, and if so, that's awesome. I haven't seen that before. Okay, now let's bring Dandelion in close. We can bring Martha up.
I'm all over it.
Hellscorn up. And last but not least.
Je suis parti.
Okay, Grellite. So we're gonna need still two turns to get there, which is like terrifying. Now, and this is where a specialist comes in really handy, and you do kind of want to tailor your squad selection to your mission type, but the challenge is you need to have vision of it. So, like, our specialist wouldn't be able to even target this because it's blocked. You'd have to be either at the side or whatever, but even still, such a huge advantage to have. We don't really have one because I just want to see if we can jump this. We can, so I kind of like this position. We could even come up here if we really wanted to. And then go around there next time. That gives us full cover from both sides. I have a feeling though, I have a bad feeling about this right side, but let's see.
Orders confirmed, on the move.
Okay, beautiful.
Position confirmée.
Orders confirmed, on the move.
I was up.
I hope it's worth it.
Hope it's worth it too. All right, everybody be on alert.
You're almost out of time. The detonator is about to blow.
Yep, thanks. I got it. No pressure. And this is kind of what I was talking about earlier, where like it's tempting, like when we were back here a couple turns ago, it's tempting to just dash up there and be like, you know, I think we got to go for it, but I honestly believe that the patience pays off a lot in these type of scenarios, so.
That's affirmative. Eyes on the target.
-1-5, this is Avenger. We have positive confirmation of the target package. Move to acquire.
Yep, working on it.
Attempting connection.
Now, the nice thing about doing these hacks with your specialist, if you have one available, this is a perfect example, actually. Your soldier's hacking stat is permanently increased by 20. Now, our tech score is only 5 because we're not a specialist and we don't have a gremlin. So our chances of getting this are insanely low. And even if we do, like, it doesn't really help us in the long run. So I really don't care about the hacking stat being increased on Grellite. Although, it's possible that he gets promoted to a specialist. So, whatever. And I'm debating this because it's a 4% chance, but those do happen sometimes, so This is the other option, delay the current Dark Event projects by 2 weeks. That's really nice because it impacts all of them. But for now, we're going to go ahead and attempt this hacking stat, because who knows. Yeah, not even close. But the detonator is disarmed, that's the important part. So now, all of the advantage has turned in our favor. We've got the tissue sample analysis.
Got some good stuff here.
Menace 1-5.
And now we can just set up
are inactive and the package is secure. Eliminate
any way that we want.
Near the AO.
Moving to designated position.
And if we catch them patrolling on us, then even better, as far as I'm concerned.
Viens par là.
Come get some.
Tout de suite.
Come get some.
I've got eyes on an
yeah, there we go. Oh, we got a couple of stunnies too. That's dangerous. Let's go, Hellscorn. Hellscorns don't miss. Okay, never mind. Olivier's don't miss, though. That's a fact. Okay, so let's see. We do have the flashbang. We have smoke. Like we're in a really good spot to take care of business here. The flashbang radius is just, like, it's insane. It's so good. Unfortunately, I can't get the guy in the back there. But I could get the two up front. He will definitely be able to charge in and stun one of us if he so chooses. I almost wonder. Like, we have grenades. We could take out these two. Then we just gotta worry about the guy in the back. We do have a decent shot here with Hellscorn. I mean, it's not ideal, but it's 58%. And even if it hits him, it's got a crit to kill him, and that I don't think is gonna happen. We do have the Deadeye, but that's gonna drop it significantly. So what I'm thinking is, we can kill him for sure without having to get in closer, because the other alternative is we bring Martha around the corner here and we go for the flank, but it's still not guaranteed. We could go for the sword attack, but again, kind of leaves us in a little bit of a tougher predicament because of this stun lancer in the back. So ideally, we keep everybody as far back as possible. We'll most likely pull back Grellite because he could probably reach. But let's start with the grenade. And actually, we may even... What I might do is... bring Olivier out here and then blow this guy's cover so that we can flashbang all of them. Let's try that. Okay, there we go. That should open up the flashbang. We can always move in closer too. Okay, so that actually doesn't quite. We're still like just slightly off, which is not a big deal.
J'y vais tout de suite.
Nice thing about flashbang and the sectoids is that they can't use their psionics. So we'll take this guy out. Still want to stay far enough away from that stun lancer if possible.
Au
On the move.
Let's bring Grellite around here. Oh my god, our guys are hitting, like, everything right now.
My ammo's running low.
That's nice when that happens. Our sniper doesn't have the best shot. I wonder if the pistol's almost better. No, it's not. So you know what? We're just gonna long watch here.
On Overwatch.
And now they've grouped up, and we could probably just launch a grenade at them. These sectoids are no joke. Hopefully that Lancer's not carrying any loot. Doesn't appear that he is. Oh, he was, damn it! That's too bad. That loot's actually really important early on. There we go. That should be it.
Hostile neutralized.
Status confirmed. All hostiles are down and the area is secure. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Nice. We did it. 100% successful shots. I mean, pretty nice when that happens. A lot of them were flanks, which, I mean, it does help. It just doesn't guarantee your shot, obviously, but, I feel as if when you have a flanking opportunity, like, even if it's 60%, you gotta take the shot.
Executed to the highest standards. Excellent work, Command.
There we go. So, let's see what Grellite's promotion is. Okay, he's a Grenadier. I'm totally okay with that. Grenadiers are, like, in my opinion, one of the best classes early on. And honestly, even later on, they're so good. Yeah, they're just gets you out of so many jams. So we did get some loot. I wonder if we got this because... Oh, that's strange. Because it did say we destroyed the loot, so I'm not sure why we have that.
Excellent work, Commander. Your efforts continue to bolster the resistance movement across the globe.
All right, this is good. Now, one of the things that we were doing previously is we had some INI edits that we did to increase the speed of building things. And instead of doing the INI edits because it's a little bit more complicated, what I'm going to do is, just for this playthrough, obviously when we do the full legend run, I won't do this, but for our base management stuff, just for this week, we'll go ahead and we'll just change the difficulty to the lowest so that I can show you guys more buildings, more of that kind of stuff. Things take a little bit, or significantly less time to build in this type of scenario. But as an example, like if we want to clear out this alien debris, I'll just show you, I'll move my engineer there for a second. On this difficulty, it takes 20 days. On legendary, or on legend, it takes 40 days. Like, that's significant. So it's something to keep in mind, but just for the purposes of this, so I can show you guys some stuff, we'll do that when we're at the base. Not really much else we can do right now. We could go and get a soldier. That might not be a bad idea. What else do we have going on, though? We have an engineer. I think that's where we were scanning previously. Looks like it's halfway done. Some of the bonuses, let's just take a look here again. So we've got hidden reserves, which give us +5 to Avenger power. Well, that's not bad. Serve mankind. Recruits cost 10 supplies. That's pretty good. Lock and load, I think, is my personal favorite. Lets your personal combat sims and weapon upgrades be reused. Like, that can't be understated how good that is. And pursuit of knowledge means each laboratory increases research speed by 20%. It's really good, but your space is pretty limited, so... Anyways, let's head back to the engineer area and hopefully grab that.
Scilab, now operational.
Beautiful. So we've got the Scilab up and running. This is obviously extremely early because of some of the edits we did previously. And that's cool. But it still takes a lot to invest in. So let's view the facility now. Okay, cool. So if we want, we can throw an engineer in there to speed up the training. We have one rookie available, but let's actually go view our soldiers. Because we switched it to the rookie difficulty at base, we're going to see a lot more promotions as well, which will let me show you guys some of the more advanced class types. So let's go ahead and give our promotions out to Hellscorn. We're going to stick with the sniper tree, and truly, I think quick draw is really only good in the hands of a gunslinger. Doesn't make sense to grab it over death from above if you're going to keep your guys at range. So let's go ahead and grab death from above, where if you kill the enemy at a lower elevation, your rifle costs only a single action. That means you can kind of, if you get the kill, you can move to a better position afterwards. Triss has been promoted. Oh, cool. And she got an Advanced Warfare Center ability. So she's got Ever Vigilant, which means if you spend all of your actions on moves, you're granted an automatic Overwatch shot at the end of the turn. So for Triss, if we just dash her somewhere, we know that we can dash her into an Overwatch, which is pretty significant, I think. Now, I tend to go back and forth on these. For this mini playthrough that we're doing, I'm going to stick with just one tree, as I mentioned before, but Heavy Ordnance is really good. Any type of grenade that's in your grenade-only slot, you get an extra use out of it, so things like flashbangs. I don't tend to use smokes that much, but flashbangs specifically, to be able to carry two of those is, like, it's amazing. Triss is still out for, like, a really long time, but... okay, let's go ahead and grab the holo targeting, and that Ever Vigilant is really nice. That's from the specialist tree later on. Also, promotion for Olivier, who is going to grab the Heavy Ordnance, the one that I was just talking about. And I'm pretty sure, let's see here, let's make our utility items available here, and let's give him the flashbang right off the get-go. So he's pretty tanky. He's got the extra armor point. It doesn't show here for whatever reason. I think when you get these additions here, that's only from things like vests or from weapon upgrades and things like that. For some reason, I wish it would, but when you have blast padding, I really believe that it should show armor plus one because you do have an armor point there, but we'll see if that's impacted later on. Beagle's got a promotion as well, and we're building him out as a true scout ranger. So Shadow Strike is really good, specifically once we get the ability to reconceal once in a mission. This extra bonus to aim and crit chance is massive. So you can get this, you can use this soldier in a lot of different ways, and I'll try to utilize that once he's not injured as much. We also got an outstanding weapon upgrade here. We could go expanded magazine. It's not bad on an assault or a ranger, but let's just hold off for now. We can decide pre-mission. Dandelion got promoted, and we're going to go Shredder. I feel that early on, specifically, Shredder is so invaluable just to get rid of those armor points on some of the tougher enemies. So let's go ahead and do that. And then last but not least, we have Elise Uyghur, who... we could build out as a phantom as well, I think. We'll go the scout tree. Okay, cool. So just keep in mind, if you guys are, and I've mentioned this a couple of times, but we're gonna be, like, further along in the tech tree and further along with soldier promotions and stuff than we normally would for a Legend playthrough. And again, the sole purpose here is just, I just want to show you guys, as much as I possibly can, and you can see how things get built. I'll be able to show you more of the research stuff, before Friday, and then once Friday comes out, we'll do a fresh start, with all of the pain and suffering that comes along with Legend. Okay, great. So we've got an engineer. This is huge. Engineers early on are, like, the best possible reward, in my opinion. So, where do we want to put him? I'm thinking about who I want to put into the Psy Lab, and I'm actually thinking about bringing in somebody from our pool here. I think what we'll do is we'll bring in Marbazir. Why not? In a lot of the review build research that I was doing, he becomes a really powerful psionic soldier, so yeah, we're gonna bring him in. So how this works, yeah, we could throw somebody in there for now. Gonna increase the training speed by 100%. So this first little amount of time that he spends in here is just to say, okay, I'm gonna be a psionic operative. Then he's gonna be assigned a random psionic power. After that, you're gonna decide from a choice of three that are always presented to you randomly, which power he's gonna train in next. On higher difficulties, they take longer to train, obviously. And let's see, we do have some alien debris here we should probably clear out. We could staff somebody in the Advanced Warfare Center for faster healing if we wanted to. It's gonna take him 5 days to train. So it'll be 10 days without the engineer. So I think I'm gonna do that and just try to accelerate our healing rates a bit. And then we'll start clearing out this debris down here as fast as we can. So we've got the workshop powering two slots in our power relay over here. That's not really ideal, and I don't even think we need that right now. Oh, okay, so we actually are over the max, so that's okay. Once this gets built out, then we're able to get an exposed power coil, and that'll probably be where we build our next power relay, and then we can kind of handle things from there. So this is actually a really good spot for the power coil. More often than not, the power coils are at the bottom row, which obviously take longer to get to. So to have this early on, this would be, I would say, a pretty good start, in my opinion anyways. So it's gonna take Marbs 10 days, but we are working on the alien debris. So we'll try to balance that out as much as we can. Now, what do we have next? We could go for a soldier if we wanted to. We still have contacts that we can make in different areas, and we should probably start doing that. We have an advent facility down here, so it makes sense that we try and contact there, but let's see what the intel cost is. It's 60, it's not bad. So let's go ahead and do that. We actually have quite a bit of intel right now.
Communications capacity. We can't establish any new contacts until we upgrade our systems.
Attempting to establish local regional contact.
And every so often, the Avatar Project makes progress. This is another thing that you have to kind of keep in mind.
Progress on the Avatar Project.
Long term.
If we're going to slow them down, we'll need to move fast.
Without spoiling too much, and, you know, we don't have any, like, embargo stuff that's saying that we can't spoil anything related to the Avatar Project. But there's a lot of things that happen that lets you reduce this progress by pretty substantial amounts, in my opinion. So you don't have to, like, stress out about it. I've had it maxed out in the past, and I've also been able to manage it just around where it is. So it kind of just depends how you want to tackle things. All right, so Oprah has been trained as our sharpshooter. Congratulations, that's great. Now let's go back into the guerrilla tactics school and we'll throw in Emrys. And I think we're gonna make another specialist. We're gonna get a few of those guys going. Natsuka's back, Beagle's back. Retaliation time. All right. So, attacking one of the resistance havens in New India, we need to respond quickly.
Setting
Let's get going.
For the Indian regional zone.
Okay, so we could take out the exact same group if we really wanted to. I think, though, what we'll do is, just for variety's sake, we'll keep Grellite. It's a moderate difficult mission, but I think it could be a lot worse. We'll keep Olivier because he got the flashbangs. Dandelion can have a seat. I don't know that we really need a specialist in this type of mission. He's got Haywire Protocol, but is that going to be even that good with only 60% 60 hacking? I don't know. And on the Terra missions, or on the Retaliation missions, I should say, there's not a lot of, like, recon towers to hack or anything like that, so I'm not going to bring him. We're going to bring out our Ranger with Beagle here, and I think that'll be pretty good. We still have Smoke if we wanted to. We could load out a bit differently. We could give the vest here just for some additional health. Yeah, let's do that. And then for weapon upgrades, we have Hair Trigger, gives a bonus action chance every 5%, or Expanded Magazine. Let's go Expanded Magazine for now. And does anybody else have an open slot? Let's see. We do. So let's go with the expanded mag here. We already have, I think, an advanced expanded mag on Hellscorn. Yeah, so this is good. And eventually when he gets the kill zone perk, that's gonna be very, very helpful. And then Grellite here. I say use it or lose it, so let's throw the hair trigger on. 5%, it's not gonna happen that often. And then let's go ahead and just change out your weapon. Let's see. Let's go with a dark green. My personal favorite pattern is probably Hex, but Grellite is a classic. So let's go classic with him. Okay, so this is going to be our squad, and we'll make sure that we switch it back to the legend difficulty for all of our missions, and we'll just tackle it after that. All right, so we'll take a break, and we'll see you guys next time. Take care. Bye.
The world you once knew is no more.